Hey folks, Vortex here, and welcome to my review of the SoundPEATS Air4. And this is also the first pair of earphones from SoundPEATS that support AptX Adaptive Lossless, or Snapdragon Sound is another word that it's called. So quite a bit different, and also they have active noise cancellation on a half in-ear type, which is again quite a bit different. Yeah, and as usual, full disclaimers, I'd like to thank SoundPEATS for sending this to me, so thank you very much. I was not paid to do this video, and all thoughts and opinions are my own. Now, as a buyer now, I've tried quite a few models from SoundPEATS, and yeah, let's just get into it. Yeah, so let's see what you get. So, only one colour, I think. I hear imagination, quite a bit vague. Bit of information there, it's a battery life, dynamic driver size, hybrid ANC. Bit more information, again quite vague considering this uses quite a high level chipset basically, so Bluetooth 5.3, obviously playtime, distance and all that good stuff. This is what they look like. I've been using them, so obviously type C, I think that's there to reset it, open it up, that's the charge level, open these out. It does look very similar to what the others look like, so that's it, kind of a matte look. It's slightly larger around here, so this part of the unit is bigger, so obviously right, obviously that's the touch part, you know, where you play in where it charges up. Again, larger than usual, and obviously I'll talk about that when I get to the review, but that's what it looks like. So there's no tips or nothing like that. That's it. So on there it says tips, there's no tips. I've seen there, you get a charge cable, super generic, I don't need to show you that, you know what it looks like. The usual paperwork. Let's quickly go over the guide while we're here. I love it straightforward. If you know SoundPEATS, you know, you'd understand this. So, first time use, how to reset, so yeah, that's the master reset. Best way kind of fit, what the buttons do. Obviously, this is another way of showing the same information, so it does quite a lot. So these actually have volume. Some of these don't have volume control. Like this one, I don't see a previous track, so power on, off, play, pause, volume up and down, next track. So there's no previous track, if that matters. Between noise reduction and normal, there's no ambient mode with these. It's either ANC on or off. Obviously, about calls, the colour of the case, you know, the charge indicator, and that's it. So yeah, in the next clip you'll see, I've actually done the microphone test already, so that's in the next clip, and then after that I'll see you for review. So this is a quick mic test of the SoundPEATS Air4. I'm speaking a normal volume in a quiet room. I'm using them in stereo, and I've connected them via Bluetooth 5.3 with AptX Adaptive, and yeah, this is just what they sound like. Yeah, so welcome to my review section of this SoundPEATS Air4. Obviously, you can have another look. I'm also going to overlay now some screenshots of the app. It's just basically the same as always. There's an adaptive EQ, which can kind of tailor-made your hearing. It can sound a bit off sometimes. Sometimes it sounds a little bit too dark. I think you either use the stock tuner or use the EQ. The adaptive may or may not work for you. Obviously, you've got game mode, which helps low latency, but it's not perfect. Obviously, you can change the ANC on and off. And obviously, yeah, you can see it shows you the battery life. So that's pretty much it. Very basic. And obviously, you need the app to update the firmware. There has been an update since I've had it. Obviously, I've applied that. Only takes a few minutes. Very straightforward. So let's talk about microphone. So you just heard it. Obviously, I'll let you judge what you think of that. So that's it. So these are very comfort is probably one. They're very similar to the rest of the lineup. Now, if you do a lot of running, jogging, I wouldn't recommend things like these because they can just fall out your ears. You'd use something more conventional or ones with ear hooks to keep you sturdy. But if you're just walking, sitting, you know, whatever, it's fine really. Obviously, these are also IPX4 rated. Obviously, these bits, if it focuses, is obviously the touch controls, which work fine. And that's pretty much it for stuff like that. So battery life is Not as good as I was expecting. So I got 4 and a bit hours, 4.5 maybe. And you get up to like, I think 20 with the case. It all depends on your volume level, or if you, it depends on what codec. So this is SB, I think SBC, AAC, AptX adaptive, lossless if you've got it. If not, it's normal adaptive. Obviously, the lower the codec, better the battery life I've seen. And the, and that's pretty much it. And also connectivity. Obviously, these are Bluetooth 5.3. These was flawless in my testing with my phone, which uses Bluetooth 5.1, I think. And I also have a Qualcomm adapter in my PC, which is Bluetooth 5.3. Absolutely perfect connection via both methods, basically. And yeah, let's talk about ANC, because it has it. There's no ambient mode. They call it hybrid ANC. No, I didn't find it, to be honest, I didn't find it very good. No, because first thing, they made this unit, I think, larger to like help it, the seal. But I still didn't think it worked very well. Really, I wasn't really that impressed by it. And yeah, so I think that's pretty much most of the stuff. Oh yeah, one thing, it's got Bluetooth, that's got multi-point connectivity, which is good to see. And yeah, so what do these sound like? So out of the box, I found these far too shouty. I'm surprised many people didn't report that. So the lower treble is quite aggressive. There is an EQ in the app, so I lowered it down a bit, and it obviously makes it much better to listen to. I was and they also seem to have a little bit, the Air3HS, I think the LDAC model, has more extension than this, so this, that sounds bigger, as has more air, is in air quotes, than these. But the overall tuning, apart from that treble spike, lower treble spike, is actually pretty good. The DD that they use is actually quite clear. Now, bass on these is elevated, but it's so dependent on the fitment. Obviously, everybody's ear canals are different. So this might be really tight for your ear canal, otherwise sometimes it might not be. So bass may be dependent on your fit, but it does have a little bit of warmth to it. Mid-range on these I thought was okay, really. Sometimes it felt a bit scooped out, but it's kind of normal from SoundPEATS kind of standard, really. Not much to say. Vocals sound fine. They sound better when you EQ down that lower treble peak. It sounded really nasally and thin. So treble on these. The treble on these is, up, say, when you calm that lower treble, but it is okay. Detail is pretty good. It's got good instrument separation. They do sound pretty good as overall kind of tuning, really. And I was quite happy with them. Now, I think the current full price in this is 80, but if you use, I think there's a discount code in the description. It does knock a lot off, so it's quite key. I don't think they're really worth the $80 price. They're worth the discount price, if that was the standard price, in my opinion. But obviously I'll talk about that in the conclusion. But yeah, kind of a short video. I'm trying to keep the Bluetooth ones shorter because I can keep waffling on. So do I recommend these? Yes, but it depends on your use case. If you are a normal consumer and you don't need the seal, if you don't need, you need ANC, if you just want tuning and like good build quality, good connection, you want the latest codec, then yeah, sure. Obviously, you need the app to calm down that lower treble, because it is too... as soon as I use these without... Obviously, there's no graph of these because I couldn't get the seal. I thought, that can't be right. It sounds really sharp. So obviously, I calmed it down. And it is better. So I do recommend, if you do get these, you have to have the app. Obviously, the case is the normal kind of compact size, which I do like from them. And so there's some cases are really big. I don't know why, but yeah, overall, they're not a bad set. I just don't think they're not worth the $80. Like, no chance. They're worth 40 to 50, really. Obviously, the ANC isn't very good, but the damp seal, it depends. If you want better ANC, buy a normal IEM unit, say, SoundPEATS sell a few. I think the Mini Pro HS, that would seal better and has ANC, which is better than this, and that's LDAC, so it's different. But anyway, I think that's pretty much it. Trying to blitz through it, because I can, as you say, I can keep waffling on. But yeah, not a bad set. They're not perfect though. It just depends if this kind of shape is what you want. And I think, yeah, if there's anything I missed, please do let me know in the comments and I will obviously answer the questions. And yeah, thanks for watching. Take care. And I've got loads of stuff in the pipeline. So subscribe so you see all that kind of funky stuff. See you in the next video.